All right, let us unbox all these. So I am going to be unboxing not only the Blackmagic 4K portable camera, but I'm also going to be opening up packages I ordered in addition to that, which were, well, we'll find out. Let's find out. All right. So, the first package, little unboxing video. Okay, first thing is small rig. So it's a rig for it. Let me open that up a little more so you can see it. Sorry, I'm having a little trouble. So I believe, I don't really know all the terms for all the camera equipment. I was doing a lot of research to see what may be the best and most affordable options of what I thought I may need in regards to additional equipment for the Blackmagic. So these are just some of the starter stuff I decided to purchase along with it. So let's open that up a little more. Wow, see that right there? We'll see how to install that onto it. I never used that before, or actually never used that before for my own personal camera, but back in college, I believe I used something like it for this old camera. Okay. There's multiple packages in one because that's sometimes Amazon just does that. Alright, so this is a UV protector for the lens. I thought that might be a good option just so then, since lenses cost so much, I wouldn't want to risk having to deal with unnecessary damage to it. So yeah, you can see, from what I remember, that didn't cost too much, but it's definitely worthwhile addition. So this is the lens, I believe. Panasonic Lumix G 25mm f1.7 ASPH. Yeah, so meaning like those are all the specs on it. It wasn't very expensive at all. I did the research to see what's a very affordable lens for, like, the best affordable lenses. And this is one I came across. And I looked at all the examples of the footage for it. And it, I obviously would want other ones, other lenses, but they were too expensive. Maybe someday I'll get to that level. So now let's open up this one. And this is my first time ever getting a high quality video camera. Before then, I only had DSLR Canon, but the one I have is not remotely par with the video quality as the Blackmagic. Alright,
different parts. Unwrap that. Yeah, that's a cage for the camera. I really hope that this isn't, I hope this is the right one. So, next, we're going to the battery. I did research on if it's possible to get a battery that could make it last quite a while, because I've heard the Blackmagic portable battery is absolutely horrible. So, like, it would only last, I've heard, about 20 to 45 minutes, versus this can last hours. This additional battery. It did cost a lot, about $100 to $200. I think it was $150, but it's definitely worth it. Rather than having to have multiple of other basic batteries. This is more convenient. Look at that. It's fancy. It's big. Big stuff. It's heavy. But I'll figure it out, you know? Figure out all that stuff. Now this is the moment we have been waiting for. It is the Blackmagic. Let's see this Blackmagic. Ooh. It just looks so magical. I've been waiting for these packages for months. I ordered this, yeah, obviously during the quarantine, and it ended up taking quite a while for everything to, yeah, it literally took a few months for everything to arrive, because the rest of the stuff was from Amazon, and I was waiting till all those arrived, versus the Blackmagic I ordered from B&H Photo, and that took only like a couple weeks. Yeah, so this just arrived in the mail, all this other stuff, about a day ago. Look at that. Look at that. Fancy. Alright, time for us to open it and see how it works. One thing I thought I may need to order is a memory card. That would be good for it. I was planning to just buy it after I got this arrived, like after it arrived, but I thought it would arrive a lot sooner, so I didn't think it would be a big deal, but apparently it's forever, so I have extra memory cards, but I don't know if they'll be powerful enough and or sizable enough for this kind of camera in regards to memory capacity. So, let's see how it all works. There's a lot of different stuff. To different countries you may go to, the or maybe different inputs or whatever. So it's very interesting. Never seen this kind of plug before. Okay. Yeah, This is more process compared to other cameras I've dealt with, because I haven't been too invested in expensive cameras. And those other cheaper cameras, you don't really encounter all this fancy equipment. So this is the battery pack. It comes with lithium battery pack, small thing. And just toss that in. Yeah. And mind you, I've never seen a Blackmagic in person. So this is a new ordeal to me, right? Let me see, what is this? I'm assuming this is a charger, it should be the charger. Oh, this you literally gotta plug in whichever applies. I believe it's this one. Maybe that's for the battery pack, I would assume. Let's see. Apparently not. So what is this for? Unless it plugs into somewhere else here. That's where the memory card goes. Oh, might be. Yep. It's right here. I'm assuming what it is you can plug it in and just use it that way. Yeah. Just like that. Like, I'm guessing instead of the battery, or maybe that's how you charge the battery. Let me plug that into the plug. Or let me first do the rest of the process of adding all that, all those features. Plug this. Great. Comes with the DaVinci Resolve Studio. That's neat. And the software for it. And a little manual too. There's a place where you can plug in the mic, HDMI. Now the question is, how do I properly remove this? I don't want to accidentally break it, considering it's a very expensive camera. It auto locks, maybe. Yep, that's what it does. When you plug it in, that charger, it auto locks, so you just gotta do lefty loosey to get that out. You learn something every day. I need some water. That was pretty hectic.
refreshing. Okay. So now let us try to put this in the gauge, right? How exactly does this work? So there's a little tool right here. Yeah, let's figure this out together, right? So we first close these sides so everything's in place and more condensed. And I'm guessing that once I get this in the cage, I'd be able to just plug in whatever and without having to remove it from it. Hopefully that's the case, because I would like it to be protected in this cage, considering how expensive and potentially fragile it may be. Did I put it in the wrong way? Nope, I did not. So I'm assuming I need to tighten it once I put it there. Okay. That must be something that I'm missing. How do I tighten? Given this tool, I don't see any place that you're supposed to tighten it. Oh, that's what, I need to be careful, that's what that is for. So, put it together. I'm assuming it's like that. Yeah. And I just put that right there. This is rather peculiar. See, this is, I'm learning how to do all this. Maybe it's at the bottom. Yep, that's where it is. So at the bottom is where I put these screws. And now let me tighten that. Now it's connected. Just like that. And there is space for me to remove the battery and everything, which is perfect. Yeah, there's space for everything, seemingly. I think I put this one right here at the top. And then, that's how it is. There's one more. I wonder where that next one would be. I'm assuming maybe on the side, or maybe it's just an extra one that was provided, or it could be one for whatever addition is added to it. I'm guessing it might be in regards to an addition, because I don't see any other places where I could put that. Okay. This ended up being a bigger camera than I thought it would be. It's not like it's big, but bigger than I thought it would be. Okay, so I can add the rig. I'll do that next, and then I can add the lens.
have zero idea where the rig is supposed to go. I'm like a complete noob right now. Oh. Is it at the bottom? Oh my god. How do I go about this? Oh, okay. Let's see this. Let me loosen this. Maybe it's this at the top. I'm assuming that might be it. It's the other way. I'm gonna look this up later though to make sure I'm actually doing this correctly. Cause I don't want anything bad to happen if I'm doing it incorrectly. I'm assuming this is how it works though, cause see. Yeah, it's seeming to work well that way. So see that? A lot of other people tend to buy all the expensive extra stuff or whatever, but I just feel that this is perfect for me, just like, you know. Someday I'll get more equipment for it. Okay. Okay. Now, let's get to the lens cap. Yay! Everybody say it with me. Lens cap. Lens cap. Yay! Alright, let's add this. Okay. Beautiful. You're beautiful. You're beautiful. It's true. I saw your face in a crowded place, and I don't know what to do. I will never be with you. Alright. Sometimes I'm absolutely garbage at putting on lenses. I don't know why. Well, I think it's right here. I gotta line it up like that. Alright. So I'm assuming it will be like left or whatever. Is it right? What the hell? It shouldn't be this hard at all. Oh dear, I cannot believe this. I would assume it would just simply line up like that. Okay, let me face it towards me. And let me line it up like that.
God.
So that's all that. Let me add the protector. This. If this even applies this kind of lens. You just gotta twist it on and it's fine. Perfect. Then I won't have to worry so much about the quality of the lens, meaning worst case scenario, I can just purchase a new lens cover rather than lens itself. Okay, I don't know what this is for. I'm guessing it's to protect it. I'm hoping. Meaning, I hope I'm not forgetting anything. So, got all that. Now the battery. This is huge. Alright. I need some water right now. Because I have a little headache. Refreshing. All right. So this goes right inside, I believe. So it's D-tap and then USB. Okay. So plugged that in, and two cords right here. I'm assuming that's not it, that's for a different country. This is for my country, the United States. This cord, so let me just toss that right there. That's it. But how does this work? I'm assuming it plugs in for USB. So this is how it charges, right? But I'm not sure if it's I'm supposed to plug this in USB. Yeah, USB apparently. Let me see. Yeah, so I'm not sure if this is what kind of USB it is. Wonder if the HDMI, yeah, no, that don't work for it. I'm not sure. Oh, it looks like the new Android kind of cable. I don't know if I have that or not. Splendid. So let's see if there's any battery in that. Not the one right here, but the one from before. Yes, there is. Wow. Oh yeah, my friend told me that this does not have autofocus, which is a problem, you know. So let's figure this out. Wow. Wow, this is incredible. Just to let y'all know. I just need to figure out, oh wait, no, I was going to say I just need to figure out how to record, but I can't record. Want to know why? Because I don't have a memory card in there. Yay. Okay. Wow, this is like a movie. I never had a video camera that's this high quality at all. Okay, let me play around with it. How did I focus again? Right there. Right? Yeah. Wow. That's neat. Let me see how to zoom out and zoom in. Or what else? Y'all are probably wondering, what am I doing right now? How cool is it? It's 180. Oh, I know. How about this? What's this do? Oh, that's a shutter. Okay. Which can affect the brightness. Let me see if it's a lower shutter. If it's any better or worse in regards to quality, FPS, frames per second. Why is it only 24? Is there a way to raise that? Okay, found some options. How do I navigate this? Oh, it's probably touch screen. Let's see. Yeah, it is. Project frame rate. Yeah, the highest, it was on the lowest, or one of the lowest frame rates. I'm going to raise it up to 60 frames per second. There's film, extended video. Preferred card for recording. I'll just use SD card. So that's what I have. Okay. Capture one frame every 10 frames. Huh. Audio LCD. Okay. Setup. Yeah, it doesn't have. Time, let me put it 2020. Today is, I believe it's June 1st right now. Is it? And time is 3. Shutter measurement, presets, LUTs, okay. Codec and quality, constant bitrate, constant quality, okay. Not sure what the, okay, that's for that. Yeah, so let me go back. What's this mean? Huh. Go. Okay. This is good.
absolutely remarkable. Okay. Where's ISO? Wonder if I load the ISO. I'll keep it at 400 for now. Perfect. Alright, I'm gonna skedaddle. I'm gonna try this out elsewhere. Bye-bye.